John Ulzheimer is known as one of our nation's most recognized credit experts. Having worked for 28 years in the credit industry, John has become one of the most prolific speakers about credit and the go-to authority on answers to credit-related questions. Credit Countdown with John Ulzheimer.
Hey there, this is John Ulzheimer, consumer credit expert. I've got almost 30 years of experience in the credit industry. Spent some time at FICO, which is the company behind the FICO credit scoring system, and Equifax, which is one of the three credit reporting agencies in the U.S. And that sound you hear in the background is, in fact, the beach. I am in Clearwater Beach, Florida, this week, attending a credit event. One of the topics, obviously, at a credit event is going to be credit scoring and credit reporting. An interesting question came up yesterday from one of the, there's like 200 people here, so a lot of good questions are coming up, giving me some really good ideas for content. And this one is specific to credit scores, and even more specifically, what credit scores do credit card issuers use? So it's a good question. You know, there are 11,000 companies in the U.S. that report information to the credit bureaus. 10,000 of them are some form of a lender. And so the majority of them have the ability to issue a credit card. So there's a ton of companies from where you could get a credit card. Most people, when they think of credit cards, they think of a handful of companies, right? Amex, Discover, and then the other really big banks, Wells Fargo, Chase, Citi, Cap One, companies like that. But you can get a credit card from any bank. You can get a credit card from any credit union. There's a lot of options. And unlike the mortgage industry, where the FHFA dictates what type of credit score has to be used, in credit card issuing, the choice is left up to the credit card issuer. And so a credit card issuer can choose to use any credit report they want. They can buy a credit report from any company, and they can choose to use any credit score that they want. There is no mandate, like there is in the mortgage industry, to use a specific type of score. Having said that, the most commonly used score in the credit card world is a FICO score that is what's referred to as an industry adjusted version or an industry option. It's a semi-customized score for bank card issuing. And FICO has several of these. They've got one for auto lending. You know, back in the day, they had one for personal finance. They had one for installment lending. They had one for mortgages. The commonly used variants of their scoring systems are bank card and auto. And so it is not unusual for a credit card issuer to use a FICO score that is not the same FICO score that your auto lender would use, or that some other type of lender, and certainly not your mortgage lender, would use. Is that a big deal? Not really. And the reason it's not a big deal is because what's important is still important. Paying your bills on time, having a clean payment history, having low utilization on your credit cards, or no utilization on credit cards, if possible. Limiting credit inquiries and having an otherwise older or well-aged credit report is still the combination that you want in order to earn really good credit scores across all credit scoring types, and even transcends credit score brands. So just because we're talking about FICO auto scores, we could drop in VantageScore credit scores, and I could give you the same advice on how to earn and maintain a solid credit score, and it would be entirely applicable for VantageScore credit scores as well, which are also very commonly used. I don't think that they're not. The two main differences between the FICO bank card score and the generic FICO score is, one is the score range. The published range for the generic FICO score is 300 to 850. The published range for these industry adjusted scores is longer than that. So you could actually score lower than 300, and you can actually score higher than 850. Having said that, you're likely gonna fall within 300 to 850, even with these adjusted scores as well. So that's number one, is the range is different. Number two is how it treats credit card accounts. So credit card issuers care about how you pay your auto loan. They care about how you pay your mortgage. What they really care about is how you pay your credit card. And so the FICO bank card score takes a second look, or a second bite at the apple, if you will, with respect to how you're using your credit cards. If you are using them responsibly, then you're going to earn more points in the bank card score, because obviously if you're treating your credit cards well, then you're a better credit risk for credit cards than you would be perhaps for some other type of an extension of credit. Conversely, if you're paying your credit cards poorly, then you're going to score worse in the bank card score than you would possibly for other types of applications like auto loans. Because again, the score, while it's a generic score and is available for any credit card issuer, is in fact a semi-customized score that is tailored more so for credit card issuer. Having said that, this is probably going to be all transparent to you because I'm telling you it, but as long as you're maintaining low utilization, you're paying your bills on time, and you've got a well-aged credit report, you're going to be fine. So that's it from here, from lovely Clearwater Beach, Florida. If you have any questions, drop them in the comment section below, and I'll do my best to get to them. Have a great rest of your day. Thanks.
For more videos and credit tips from John Ulzheimer, go to www.tradelinesupply.com.